Srimati Supriya Sule.
Sir, thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to speak on such an important social subject. I congratulate the minister for bringing this back, but there are few questions I would like to ask the honorable minister. Exactly 1 year ago, we all debated this issue. Sir, what has been achieved in 1 year? This has gone and it got stuck in Rajya Sabha. And one thing which I get the sense from everybody in this house, nobody is against the social change. But I have one humble question to ask you. With full humility, please put your hand on your heart and tell me that this is not political and your agenda is only social. Why did you use the ordinance route and not a consensus route is my first question to ask you if this is only a social issue. I appreciate Smriti Irani ji's intention as well as Meenakshi Lekhi ji. They were talking what Smriti ji said. I appreciate, I actually expected a longer speech from you. But my question to you was, you talked about 477 cases which has happened. I feel even one happens is bad. Why should we wait for 477? But at the same time, this is a social issue. We made laws for dowry. We made laws for child marriage. Have things really changed? We are all people from the field. We are all elected members. We are totally connected. I'm not against what it is done. I'm against the way it is done. And the whole sense of the group is, when we make, what is this act for? Is it for reconciliation of marriages? Which I appreciate what Meenakshi Lekhi ji said in her speech. What she said in her speech was, she used a particular word and she said that we come from very cultured families where we want our marriages to work. A woman stays in her marriage even if the marriage is bad because of her family and her commitment to her children. So by putting him in jail, which is the minimum sentiment of this entire house, which marriage is going to be saved by putting an husband? And is really this is what reconciliation is about, that every time you go, you're going to threaten your husband? So I think what you have said, you have definitely diluted many things that we have recommended. I appreciate that. But have we achieved the final goal? And again, it goes back to the square of the basics. This is not for the women on top of the pyramid. This is the women at the bottom of the pyramid. This issue is not about Sushmita, me, Meenakshi or Smriti ji. We know what our rights are. This is not law made for us. It's for women who are at the bottom of the pyramid who are unaware of their rights. So why don't we work harder than putting the husband in jail, explaining to women, you really want to empower women? Put your hand on your heart. Bring in, I'm so glad Menka ji is sitting here. Why don't you look at other bills which will give us justice, which is like a bill which she has been talking about against marital rape. Why aren't we talking about bills like that, which will genuinely, because that women's reservation bill, we've been asking for, it is even in your manifesto if I'm not wrong. So why are we not bringing that? Empowering women financially and emotionally will really strengthen the cause. I'm not against it. Triple talaq must instantly stop. I don't think anybody, whether you're sitting on this side or this that side, disagrees with you. The only thing we disagree with is if you are looking at institution of marriage, if you're talking about stakeholders, Nakvi ji talked about stakeholders. I want to tell you a small little story that I went through. When I was coming back from my constituency day before yesterday, Smriti ji is a Bombay girl, she knows about this place. While coming back through the expressway, you pass through Crawford Market. I was looking at the hijab shops there and I thought to myself, I'm going to speak on triple talaq for the second time. Should I really ask these women what is their view? You won't believe, Smriti ji knows where Haj House hai building. Waha mein utri gaadi se and I started walking the street. I met a girl with a burqa and she had two young girls and the husband walking together. And they turned out to be from Aurangabad. They stopped. They even know Asad bhai. And they stopped and they told me, please, what are you doing on the road? I said, there is triple talaq debate. I wanted to know, you are the real stakeholders. I am not going to be the victim. You may be the victim. So what is your view on this? So he said, no, no, these are not issues. Nobody should be criminalized. His wife immediately got into the thing. And she said, Supriya, dekho, ye meri dono doctor hai ladkiya. Unka bhi raay hai aur main ek teacher hoon. Main kabhi mere shohar ko jail nahi bhejungi. Sahan karungi, lekin husband ko jail nahi karungi, mere bachon ka paap hai. This is what she said to me. Not only that, you have to sentiment of women, it's reality. I can give you the name. I'm not giving you data which are fudged numbers. I will give you the name and mobile. Please call and find out what these women think. My feet are ground. I don't work for, I don't give database. I genuinely work for women empowerment. I'll give you another example. And another young lady called Kiran Kulkarni, she's a Maharashtrian Brahmin girl, walked up to me in a burkha. And she started talking to me. And she started talking to me in Marathi. I said, aap kahan ke? She said, maja nao Kiran Kulkarni. Me Marathi Brahman hai, Musalman man. So she lagna kela. I said, tumhi burkha galta. So I said, aap burkha pehnti hai. She said, haan, because I'm very proud of what. And she is today, she has done M.Com. She's done her PhD in political science. She lives in a place called Chalna. She told me that, Supriya, my humble request is, don't get involved in all this. Support, no religion teaches you bad. No religion in the world. It's people like us who misinterpret it and misuse it. That's the point I'm making. So why are we getting into these issues? That's exactly what she said to me. She said to me, my marriage was of love. This man has given her all the freedom in the world. She studied. She was only 19 when she married this man. She was an undergraduate. She graduated and did her PhD after getting married to this man. She lives in Ambad and today she teaches the Quran to people. Imagine a girl named Kiran Kulkarni today is Mrs. Chaus, who lives in Jalna in Ambad and Aurangabad and leads a life with parents. So this is what integration is about and that's what woman has about. Woman is about. So my limited point to you is, if you really in leading from the front in the armed forces, what did the armed forces say last week about us women? That we women, the chief said, that we cannot lead from the front. Who says so? If the prime minister of this country can be a woman, if a president of India, a defense minister can be a woman, why cannot a woman lead? Tell me a platoon and win the war for this country. So please do not underestimate the power of a woman. A woman is very powerful, but at the same time, when a woman cries, you say one small thing to her, she will immediately cry. But when there's a crisis in her life, that same woman stands up, even if she's a widow or a single woman, she will stand up and deliver towards her family. So I urge to you, sir, that this time is not about being hostile. If you really wanted to bring in this, you should have brought in by consensus. And what heavens are going to fall once you go to Rajya Sabha? Rajya Sabha is anyway not functioning. At least I'm glad we are in Lok Sabha, we are working every day. Rajya Sabha every day shuts at 11:15. So once this goes from here to Rajya Sabha in the next 7 days, what is going to change? Why are we not looking at, and if you're worried about women so much, why are we not looking about women who are deserted? And today, what difference is it going to make? And many women, women are not only Hindu, Muslim, Jain, Christian. Women's issues, if this government is Beti Padhao, Beti Bachao, we are happy about it, then make sure our education says increases for women. Women rights have been told. Women are financially and emotionally given empowerment. That is going to be the changing the picture. And if you give us reservation, my state was the first state to give reservation to women in power. So why don't you do that? Instead of discussing triple talaq, let's finish this debate and get into women's reservation bill. This whole house wholeheartedly will stand by you and we can pass it, and in the next election we can do that. So I urge the honorable minister and the government to rethink it. All everybody is saying is, the worry is, if she gets triple talaq or with this hostile environment, where is he going to pay for all these things? These are very critical issues. And nobody is asking for select committee for Evans. Everybody's agreed. Take 2 weeks. In the budget session, 5 days, we will first address this issue and then we can talk about the budget. So I have a humble request to you that this is a family issue. It's a social issue. And people talked about contracts. Marriages of contract doesn't mean it's not of two people and two hearts and families. In India, only husband and wife don't live together, sir. Two families get married. So there's a lot of sensitivity that goes into it. So please look at this entire legislation with the heart, not just by law. Anyway, it's null and void. So why not bring it? So let elections will come and go, sir, but social change takes time. We've made so many legislations. I make a humble request. Please rethink it, reconsider it with the heart. Votes will come and go, but right and wrong, generations will get affected, sir. Thank you. Yes.